Everyone, it's Danny here, and today I'm working on this two-door reaching cooler. Customer called me earlier and told me that there's a funky smell and the temperature is not going down to the correct temperature. So here's the model number and serial number. And the first thing I notice is that the evaporator fan is not working, not spinning. So first thing I'm going to do is check if there's power going to the evaporator fan. As for coolers, the evaporator fan should run all the time. So first thing I'm going to do is take off the cover. This is a very old fridge, very dirty too. Open this junction box. Seems that already someone has opened this up. It's definitely not manufacturer wiring. Second thing I'm going to do is open this screw now. Then I'm going to find the power that goes to the fan. Should be the two small skinny black wires. So one's this one and the other one is this white. So one of these should have power. One of them has power, that means that there is power going to the evaporator fan. Right there. One of these two. I'm going to get my voltmeter. So I got one on the hot leg and one on 20 ground. Gotta make sure I get good connection. It's kinda hard filming. I got that on ground. And I got 120 volts. So there is power going to the evaporator fan motor. And the evaporator fan motor is not spinning. So the compressor, so the evaporator motor is burnt. Now what I'm going to do, so after I've done that, I can also touch the fan motor and it's very, very hot. And this is also spins very stiff, the fan blade. So what I'm going to do now is take out the evaporator fan motor. After I shut off the power to the cooler, I'm going to take it out and install the new one. This one right here. Let me see if I get a good angle for you guys. So first thing I did is turn off the evaporator, sorry, the power to the whole system. Sorry about that, guys. Had a call coming. Okay, so first thing I did was disconnect power to the cooler. And now I'm gonna double check to see if I have power still. Perfect, no voltage. So now we can go ahead and take out the two wires that go to the evaporator fan. Take that out. Like so. That motor is piping hot. Now I'm going to take the screws out. Make sure you hold on to the screws. And make sure they don't fall into the food that's already in the fridge. So now that we got that out, we can just take out these two nuts, then replace the fan motor. Here's the new one, and that's the old one. This fan motor is piping hot. Even the nuts are hot on the screws. Hopefully the switch, this should fit right in. The existing poles. Now when you're changing these skeleton fan motors, you want always want to make sure that the copper side is on the same side as the new one. So in this case, they're both matching, so it's perfect. So this goes in like this. Just gonna want to have to bend these. Gonna cut this off first, like so. So this should fit right in. That. Now before I put this on, I want to make sure that the fan blade is the same size. And turns the same way. Hot. I'm gonna take it off. That way I can do more accurate, and there you go. It's perfect. Sometimes I get lucky. So now I can go ahead and tighten the bolts on the back. So now it's on tight. This is the old one. You see it on like that. This one's on like that. And the old fan blade was on like this. Same curve. Same thing. Everything. Just this one's wider, which is even better. Could move more air per spin. And now we can put these back on now. Thank you. Now, before I put the cover back on, I'm gonna see if the fan works now. I'm gonna plug it in. Voila! The fan is now working.